सर्वेभ्यः अद्वैत चिंतन वर्गे सर्वेषां स्वागतम्। अपरोक्ष भावानुभूति जायमाना अस्ति। श्रीमत् शंकराचार्य विरचित श्लोकम् अस्ति एवं विद्यामुनि मुनिन्या कृत दीपिका व्याख्या सहितम्। ओम वक्रतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसमप्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ओम नमः परमर्षिभ्यो नमः परमर्षिभ्यः। ललिता भगिनी शांति मंत्र प्रथम श्लोक।
ओम पूर्णमद विशेष सहना भवतु नो सॉरी सॉरी
सहना भवतु एंड श्री हरि बोथ श्लोक
ओके। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ। श्रीहरिं परमानन्दम् उपदेष्टारमीश्वरं व्यापकं सर्वलोकानां कारणं तं नमाम्यहम्।
धन्यवादः भगिनि। We have been in the last class, the first sloka were the Dehatmavadinaha, or those who think the body is the Atma, Aham Dehavan, Deham Eva Atma. I am my, this Sharira, this body which I am enjoying or I am knowing everything through this body, so I am the body, and that itself is everything is what the Dehatmavadin is believing. So that is the most, what you call, established notion among every human being. So we cannot, there is no group or any special cult or anybody who can, whom we can call it as Dehatmavadin. Sadharanataya, ordinarily everybody thinks I am the body, or the, with the body as a as I, all interactions in our world takes place with that. So if something happens to the body, I say that it's paining me, it is, I am happy, sorrow, and I'm feeling hot and cold, then comes the relationship with the body. Then my idam mama, I am idam mama, all adjectives of relationship with the body. And the feeling of mine and that mama, that is so much related to the body. And because of that is all the vyavahara. So that is what we have to first and foremost and ensure that bodham, which is so rudimentary and deeply established in all of us from the childhood onwards, and because of which all the problems or all the relationship, whether it is good or bad or sukha or dukkha, all those are related to the body. So it becomes very important for the acharya to repeatedly drill into our mind that the deha is not the atma. So kasmat katam syat dehaga puman is being repeated in the next 5 slokas. So the second part is repetition of the same meaning what we studied in the last class, But what is the first line and part of the second line beginning is the one which keeps changing for the next five slokas. So, Shobha Bhagini, can you read the sloka in the Padacheda Annoya?
Aham Mahodaya. Kshamatam. Aham Shabdena Vikhyata Eka Eva Sthita Paraha Sthulatvanekatam Praptaha Katam Syaddeha Kahpuman Padachedaha Aham Shabdena Vikhyata Eka Eva Sthitaha Paraha Sthulahatu Anekatam Praptam Katam Syat Deha Kahpuman अन्वयः परः अहम् शब्देन विख्यात एक एव स्थितः स्थूलः तु अनेकतां प्राप्तः देहकः कथं पुमान् स्यात् तदेव आह अहम् इति इत्यादि अहम् इत्यादि सप्तभिः परः तदेव आह अहम् इत्यादि सप्तभिः परः देहादन्यः आत्मा अहम् शब्देन शब्द इत्युपलक्षणम् शब्द इति उपलक्षणम् प्रत्ययस्य अपि विख्यातः प्रसिद्धः किम् लक्षण इत्यत आह एक इति एक एव स्थितः एव इति प्रत्येकम् अवधारणम् तु शब्दः पूर्वोक्तात् आत्मनः स्थूलदेहस्य वैलक्षण्यद्योतकः स्थूलो देहकः देह एव देहकः स्वार्थे कः प्रत्ययः कथं पुमान् पुरुषः आत्मा स्यात् न कथञ्चित् इत्यर्थः देहस्य अनात्मत्वे हेतुम् आह अनेकताम इति अनेकताम परस्परम भिन्नता प्राप्तः एवं तमः प्रकाशवत् इति विलक्षणत्वेपि देहस्यात्मत्वं ब्रूवन्नति मूढत्वादुप उपेक्ष्या इति भावः तत्र ब्रूवन् अतिमूढत्वात् उपेक्षया इति भावः
धन्यवादः
महोदय
अहम् शब्देन इति अहम् सो विख्यात एक एव स्थितः परः परः इत्युक्ते परमात्मनः स्थूलत्वात् अनेकतां प्राप्तः देहः कथं स्यात् देहकात् पुमान् दिस् इस् द श्लोक एण्ड् इफ् यु लुक् अट् द अन्वय परः अहम् परमः परः मीन्स् उन्नतः और् उत्कृष्टः अहम् शब्देन विख्यातः एक एव स्थितः Now, if you look at that aham shabda, the shabda is, aham is well known to everyone. But that aham shabdam, even though it is well known to our all, even though in any language it is said in different languages, you say the aham, I, in either Tamil or Telugu or Kannada or your German or English or Japanese or Chinese, whatever may be the language. The aham shabdam is vikhyata, loka prasiddha. Everyone knows the word aham in their own languages. Yet, eka eva sthitaha, that experience of aham is eka eva sthitaha, is the same for everyone, whether a Chinese says or a Japanese says or a German says or an Indian says, when they use the language of their own language, they say I or aham. That is the feeling of that is the same for everyone. So why when you say aham and when I say aham, the intended meaning or the experience which both of us have is eka. There is no difference between when you say I and when I say I. that experiencer aspect or drishtara is not differentiated. If in spite of that, stulatu anekata, deham, if you look at it, it is anekata. That person's body, your body is different, mine is different, the Japanese is different, Chinese is different, German, English, or anybody for that matter, is different. Anekatam praptaha. So difference is for that body. Yet the aham shabda vikhyatam is well known to us. So how can you compare katam syat puman the dehaka? Now I'll read the vyakhyanam. Tadeva aha aham ityadi saptabhihi. The saptabhihi thing I told you, deham sharirathrayam, deha sushma shariram and manovi buddhi ahankara citta four, that saptabhihi. Paraha deha danyaha atma. Paraha it is deha danyaha. Para means it's always different. Anyaha is the meaning. So here deha danyaha is the para. And that itself is atma. Aham chabdena shabda iti upalakshanam pratyasya api. So upalakshanam, there is a upalakshanam of the shabdasya upalakshanam upayujya. Using that pratyasya. Vikhyada means prasiddha. Kim lakshanam iti aha. What is the lakshana of everything? Eka eva. Eka iti eka eva sthitaha. It is the uniqueness of that aham shabdasya pratyayalambanam. Pratyayasya alambanam. Vikhyadam asti. So that experience of I, even though it is unique and common in all those who are using the word, it eka ivi pratyekam avadaranam tu shabdaha purvaktvad atmanaha. So it is referring that tu is we seeing referring to the same sloka, the previous sloka atmanaha is what is being explained as the word tu shabdasya. Atmanaha stula dehasya vailakshanya dotakaha. What is atmana? Stula dehasya vilakshanatvam bodhayati. It separates out the stula deha from the experiencer or the perceiver is different from the perceived. Stula dehakaha. Deha eva dehakaha. Swarte kaha pratyaya. So the kaha pratyaya is a tadida pratyaya which is used to show diminish or denote balaha balakaha. When you say balakaha, it means a smaller child. Bala means a young boy. But balakaha, when you say the kaha pratyaya, when you add it, tadida pratyaya, when you add it, it is that becomes diminished or the smaller one. So the word dehaka with the kaha pratyaya is Vidyarne Muni says that swate kaha pratyaya is added to decry the word the dehatma vadit. Kadan katam puman purushaha atma syat he dehatma vadin eka eva atma shabda aham shabda pratyayalambanena eka eva sthitaha api katam sa purusha atma deham syat na katanchit ityartha. It can never be the atma. So dehasya anatmatve hetu aha anekatam. Why it is anatma? Deha is anatma anekata. Whereas atma is that I-ness or the feeling of the sense of the knower, the drishta, aham is ekaha. Whereas deha is anekata. Iti anekatam parasparam vinnata prapta evam tamaprakashavat iti vilakshanatve api dehasya atmatvam bruvan atimodatvat upekshya iti. So it is extreme modatva to tell that this deha is atmatvam because tamaprakashavat iti vilakshanatvam asti. One is an object which is being illumined by the Atma, Swatma Prakashatvam. Deha has no Prakashatvam of its own. You need your awareness to enlighten even your body. not only your body, the entire jagat or prapancha through experience through the body has to be illumined by the swatma prakasha. So, and that is ekaha in all the bodies. So, if you, you definitely anyone who says I has the same experience as when I say I, when you say I, or when a third person says I, all of us have the same experience of I apart from the body. And all of us observe our body as an object of observation or a perception. So how do you compare these two together is what the acharyas asked in this particular sloka. In the next sloka is Chandumarya.
अहम् द्रष्टया सिद्धो देहो द्रश्यतया स्थितः ममायमिति निर्देशात् कम ममायमिति निर्देशात् कथम् स्यादः कः पुमान् पदच्छेदः अहम् द्रष्टतया सिद्धः देहे द्रष्टतया स्थितः ममायम इति निर्देशात् कथम् स्याद् देहकः पुमान् अन्वयः अहम् द्रष्टतया सिद्धः देहे द्रश्यतया स्थितः अयम् मम इति निर्देशात् कथम् स्याद् देहकः पुमान् तत् एव अतिवैलक्षणम् दर्शयति अहम् इति अहम् शब्दप्रत्याय लम्बनम् आत्मा द्रष्टतया शब्दादि विषयप्रकाशकतया सिद्धः शब्दं शृणोमि इत्यादि व्यवहारेण प्रसिद्धः देहः तु द्रश्यतया शब्दादिवत् प्रकाश्यतया स्थितः तत्र हेतुम् आह मम इति मम अयम् देहः इति घटादिवत् स्वयसम्बन्धितया निर्देशात् व्यवहारात् एवम् उभयोः वैलक्षण्ये सति कथम् देहकः पुमान् स्याद् इति व्याख्यातार्थः चतुर्थपादः एवम् अग्रे अपि बोधव्यम्.
सम्यक्, धन्यवादः महोदय.
धन्यवादः.
अहम् दृष्टतया सिद्धः देहः श्रद्धतया दृश्यतया स्थितः मम अयम् इति निर्देशात् कथम् स्यात् देहः पुमान् अन्वयः अहम् दृष्टतया सिद्धः देहः दृश्यतया स्थितः अयम् मम इति निर्देशात् कथम् स्यात् देहः पुमान् नौ हि इस् आस्किंग् ए क्वश्चन् टु द देहात्मवादि दृग्दृश्य विवेकम् और द डिफरेन्स् बिट्वीन् द दृष्ट एण्ड् द दृश्यम् is what it is being explained in this particular shloka. Drishtataya siddhaha. Drishtaram. Aham. Iti siddhaha. Dehatu drishyataya siddhaha. Yatha ghatavat. In the vyakhya is coming that. So, and not only that, because of the deha, we say I am mama iti. Nirdeshat. Now he's asking, how can you compare these two together? Katam chat deha kapuman. Tat eva ati vailakshanyan darsheti ahamiti. Now the vilakshanata between the deha and aham is being explained in this sloka. Aham aham shabda pratyayalambanam atma. So atma is a pratyaya alambanam of aham aham shabdasya. Ityukte Atma is known by the pratyaya aham pratyaya. This aham shabdasya pratyayalambanatvat atma drishtataya shabdatihi vishaya prakashataya siddhaha shabdam shrunomi ityadi. So even shabdadi means all the sense organs you have to take. Shabdadi vishaya prakashataya, all that vishaya which is coming through the five indriyas, shabda shabda sparsha rasa roopa gandha, all those indriyas which are bringing the vishayas, that is being illumined by the atma pratyalam ahamaha satyalambanam atma shabdam shrunomi. So the sound is being heard by me, is being illumined by that atma. So the shrota is different from the shabdam. So shrunomi, when we say that shrunomi, you are using the word kriyapadam shrunomi, aham shrunomi, na tu deham shrunomi, right? So that difference, you, even though you use it, we use it in our own transaction, I am hearing you, but we don't say my body is hearing. So shabda, not only shabda, but all the five sense organs, when they give the input through the body, the drishta or the one who is seeing that is different from that. So aham shrunomi ityadi vyavaharena prasiddha. So in even by the vyavahara by which we do that aham shrunomi, so aham pratyaya aham shabda pratyayalambanam atma iti prasiddha. Dehaha tu drishyataya shabdadivat prakashataya stitaha. So tatra deha drishyataya shabdadivat, even shabda is an object for aham to hear. Aham shrunomi, when you are saying, or when you are saying aham shrunomi, it is a object which is being acknowledged by the aham shabda. You are not saying aham shabdam asmi, but we are saying aham shrunomi. That is the difference between the two. I am hearing the sound, the sound is different from me. Same way, all the indriya vishayas, vishaya prakashataya siddhaha, it's all by object. Vishaya is object. Prakashataya, by illumination of the object, siddhaha, aham shrunomi, ityadi, vyavaharena prasiddhaha. So it's only the transactional, from the transaction point also, it is very, very prasiddhaha, very, very well known that there is a I different from the all the sensory inputs which is coming to the through the body. Dehaha tu drishyataya shabdadivat prakashataya prakashyataya. Atma tu prakashataya drishyataya shabdadivat prakashyataya stitaha tatra etu maha mama iti mamam ayam deha iti gadadivat. So everything other than aham, that pratyayalambanam, aham shabdasya, yet prasiddha asti, whatever is that well-known I, in whichever language we use it, everything else is drishyataya prakashataya bhinnaha, because it is being seen. Seen is not only for seen, you have to take for the all indriyas, shabda sparsha rasa roopa gandha. So it is being illumined by the aham. Prakashataya atma prakashataya shabdadi sarvan vishayan tatra edu maha mama iti aham ayam dehaha iti gadadivat swiya sambanditaya nirdeshat vyavaharat evam ubayo vailakshane sahi kadam dehaka. So now that question is being asked, just as gadadrishta gadad binnaha, shabdadrishta shabdad binnaha, रसदृष्टा रसदृष्टा रसाद् भिन्नः एवमेव ऑल दोस इंद्रिया इनपुट्स और विषयास एंड दैट इज बीइंग सीन और ऑब्जर्व्ड और परसीव्ड और एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाय एन एंटिटी विच इज अहम प्रत्ययालंबनम बाय द वर्ड विच एवरी लैंग्वेज और एवरी पर्सन यूजेस इज अहम दैट इज डिफरेंट वैलक्षण्य सरी हाउ डज दैट उभयोः बिटवीन द टू देयर इज टोटल डिफरेंस I mean the bifurcation or the difference between the two is very very clear. Vailakshanya sati katam deha ka puman? How do you call it as puman syat puman itrukte atma syat? Iti vyakhyarthaha chaturtha pada evam agre api bodhamyam. Now this fourth padam that is four padas in a shloka. First two are in the top line. Third and fourth are in the bottom line. The tatra katam syat deha puman is being repeated in the coming next four slokas. So that he is not going to explain those points, I mean describe, or he is not going to do vyakya for those katam syat deha puman again. So iti agrevi bodhavyam. So we have to take it from anuvritti, we have to take it from this sloka. So what it is being very clearly said is that in our day-to-day transaction, if we can bring in this experiencer and experienced all the time, every moment of life, bodham bodham prati, every bodham is an input through the one of the sense organs, and there is bahyendriya and antarendriya, both are giving us the input. But tasteshan drishtara to anya, the one who is perceiving them, whether it is an internal object like sukha dukkha or the emotions or thoughts or anything that is happening internal, or even what is happening in the dream or the daytime, doesn't make a difference. But all that is being perceived by the aham pratyayalambanam. There is an I which is able to distinguish between ubayo vailakshanyam sati. So that vilakshanata between the these two is very very clear. Yatohi, even though that is being the case, aham deha iri vyavahriyate, our day to day interaction or in the world is mama, I am mama deha, I am mama. So we all the interaction vyavahara happens with as if I am the deha. This is katam syadiri. This is what the acharya is asking in this sloka, which will be repeated in the following slokas also. Vijaya Bhagini, namaste. Vijaya Bhagini, Shiva. Okay, Lalita Bhagini, can you read that?
Huh. I'll read. अहम् विकारहीनस्तु देहो नित्यं विकारवान् इति प्रतीयते साक्षात् कथं स्यात् देह कपुमान् पदच्छेदः अहम् विकारहीनः तु देहः नित्यं विकारवान् इति प्रतीयते साक्षात् कथं स्यात् देह कपुमान् अन्वयः अहम् विकारहीनः अस्मि तु देहः नित्यं विकारवान् इति प्रतीयते साक्षात् कथं स्यात् देहः पुमान् पुनः वैलक्षण्यान्तरम् आह अहम् इति अहम् व्याख्यातार्थः विकारहीनः जायते अस्ति अस्ति त्याद सीयादि जायते सीया सी इत्यादि षड् विकारहीनः तु वैलक्षण्ये देहः अनित्यं सर्वकालं विकारवान् अत्र किं प्रमाणम् अत आह इति 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 साक्षात् प्रत्यक्षप्रमाणेन प्रतीयते अनुभूयते एवं सति कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् इति।
अस्तु धन्यवादः भगिनि। ओके अत्र अहं विकारहीनः देहा तु नित्यं विकारवान् इति प्रतीयते साक्षात् तत् कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् देहक स्यात् इति that is a question which is again being repeated I think here is another aspect of it now drishyam drishtam drish drishtam idi that is even the previous shloka so here it is the vikaratvam of the two aham vikarahinah asmi dehah tu nityam vikaravan idi sakshat pratiyate तत् कथं पुमान् स्यात् देहक इस् अ क्वश्चन् बीङ्ग् आस्क्ड् पुन वैलक्षण्यान्तरम् आह अहम् इति अहं व्याख्यातार्थः विकारहीनः जायते स्थित्या इति स्थिति षट्विकारहीनः तु वैलक्षण्ये देह अनित्यं सर्वकालं विकारवान् अत्र किं प्रमाणम् अत आह इति इति साक्षात् प्रत्यक्षप्रमाणेन प्रतीयते अनुभूयते एवं सति कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् इति नौ द विलक्षणता आफ् बिट्वीन् अहम् एण्ड् द देह ईस् बीङ्ग् अगेन् ब्राट् इन् बै द आचार्य एण्ड् द व्याख्यात अहं व्याख्यातार्थः ईस् विकारहीनः फ्रम् ए चैल्ड् वेन् यु आर् अन् युर् ग्राण्ड् फादर्स् लाप् दिस् इस् एन् एक्साम्पल् विच् Vachaspati Mishra uses in the Brahma Sutra Bhashya Vyakhyanam, Bhamati Vyakhyanam. When I was sitting on my grandfather's lap, I had an experience of I. Even as a toddler or a child, young child. Today, when my grandchild is sitting on my lap, that I, the feeling of I even has not even changed a wee bit between the two. So between from a toddler to the grandfather stage, when I have experienced I, the I-ness or the aham experience have never gone through a change, vikarahinaha, which is without any modification. So from that moment, whenever you remember that aham, from that time to the time when you know now, your I-ness or our I-ness, which we experience at every moment of life, has not gone through any modification. Na vikarahinaha. Shat vikarahinaha. Sthiti, janma, vriddhi, apakshaya, nasha, ityadi. Shat vikarahina. So, sthiti, sthityadi. That is the word, sthityadi. So, to show the shat vikarahinaha. The aham pratyayam or the experience of aham has not gone through a janma, vikara, mrityu, apakshayam. All the shat vikaras have never happened to the aham pratyayam, the experience of I. Whereas dehaha anityaha, the body with which I am talking to you to this moment is not going to be the body which I speak by the time I end the sentence. Because so much of cells have changed in my body in today's modern scientific methods. And olden days, they know that to what body you are having today is not the what body we are having tomorrow. Balastavat, Karunastavat, Vriddhastavat, we have heard all those slokas. We know that all those vikara is happening to the body. When he is referring to the body, please understand, he is not referring to our deha alone. Through the deha, he is talking the entire prapancha. So, everything in the world is changing except the aham pratyaya lambanam. The experience of what we call it as aham has never changed. Sarva kalam vikaravan deham. Atra kim pramanam ata aha iti that word iti is used for what? Sachat pratyaya pramanena pratiyate anubhuyate is what is being explained by the word iti. Iti sachat. Iti pratiyate sachat kadam syat dehaga puman is the last second sentences. No? So pratiyate is sachat iti. So here also all the changes are an object of perception, pratyaksha pramanamati. Because in the indriya gocharatvam is what the body's changes are happening. You have experience of your body changing from one stage to another stage, or one day to another day, or from the different modes of life when it is changing, even when your internal body also. How the mental moods change, how the emotions change, how the intellectual thoughts change, how the values and beliefs in life change. Everything is going changed, and that is sakshat. Sakshat, akshat, it is directly perceivable by us. So pratyaksha pramanam asti. All these are changing is a pratyaksha pramanam when referring to aham pratyayalambanam, when the body is being taken as a pratyaksha pramanam. All the changes are an object of perception for the aham pratyayalambanam, the I-ness in which is observing all those things. Then how can you say that Puman, the Atma, is Deha? How do you say that the Deha is the Atma? Is the question again asked by the Acharya, again to the Dehatmavadi. Now, having told this Pratyaksha Pramana and the Pramanas which are there in the Drishya Drishta, Drudrishya Vivegatvat, all those things, now in the next verse, he is even going to quote the Shruti, which is a support for this. So, Shobha Bhagini?
आमोदय यस्मात् परिमिति श्रुत्या तया पुरुष लक्षणं विनिर्णीतं विमूढेन कथं स्याद् दहकः दहकः एव
देहकः
अस्तु कथं स्याद् देहकः पुमान् पदच्छेदः यस्मात् परम इति श्रुत्या तया पुरुष लक्षणं विनिर्णीतं विमूढेन कथं स्यात् देहकः पुमान् पदच्छेदः अन्वयः इति मन्ये तत्र विमूढेन यस्माद् परम् इति श्रुत्य तया पुरुषलक्षणं विनिर्णीतं कथं स्यात् देहकः पुमान् पुनरेकवारं पठामि विमूढेन यस्माद् परम् इति श्रुत्य तया पुरुष लक्षणं विनिर्णीतं कथं स्यात् देहकः पुमान् एवं युक्त्या देहात्मनोः वैलक्षण्यं उक्त्वा श्रुत्या अपि आहा यस्मात् इति यस्मात् परं नापरम् अस्ति किञ्चिद् यस्मात् नानीयो किञ्चिद् अस्माद् वा न किञ्चिद् यस्मात् किञ्चित् यस्मात् अस्तु किञ्चिद् यस्मात् यस्मान् नानीयो
यस्मात् नानीयो
न नीयो यस्मात् नानीयो
न अनीयो
न अनीयो न अनीयो न ज्यायोस्ति कश्चित् न ज्यायोस्ति कश्चित्
न ज्यायः अस्ति कश्चित्
ज्यायः
ज्यायः विसर्गस्य ओकार अस्ति
ज्यायः इति अस्ति तत्र
न ज्याय अस्ति कश्चित्
अस्तु न ज्याया अस्ति कश्चित् वृक्ष इव स्तब्धः दिवि तिष्ठत्येकस्तेनेदं पूर्णपुरुषेण सर्वं इति तया प्रसिद्धया तैत्तिरीयश्रुत्या कृत्वा इति कारणे तृतीया पुरुषस्य आत्मनः लक्षणं विमूढेन किल तत्र विमूढेन विगतमूढभावेन अतिचतुरेण श्रुत्यर्थे विवेचनकुशलेन इत्यर्थः इयं कर्तरि तृतीया विनिर्णीत विचार्यः स्थापितं अन्यत् पूर्ववत् यद्वा श्रुत्या इति कर्तृपदम् अस्मिन् पक्षे विमूढेन इति देहात्मवादिनं प्रति संबोधनं विमूढानां इना स्वामिन् मूर्खशिरोमणित्वात् एव अति न अद्रियसे इति भावः।
धन्यवाद भगिनी।
धन्यवाद महोदय।
यस्मात् परम इति श्रुत्या तस्य पुरुष लक्षणं विनिर्णीतं विमूढेन कथं स्यात् देहकपुमान् अन्वयः विमूढेन यस्मात् परम इति श्रुत्या तया पुरुष लक्षणं विनिर्णीतं तदं कथं स्यात् देहकपुमान् अत्र हियर I told you, he is quoting a Shruti. Yuktya, Shrutya, Swanubhavam. This is the three ways in which Advaita is establishing any point. It has to be logical. Yukti, then Shruti, Shrutya, and Swanubhavam. What Yukti is saying, what Shruti is saying, you have to apply to your own Anubhava. If the three are matching and telling the same, then how can you not accept it? That is the advantage of Advaita. It is not asking you to just follow what is told in a book or a dictum by some preachers or books and teachers. You have to use your yukti, you have to use shruti vakya, and that has to be applied in the anubhava. Swanubhavam asti ched. So, for example, when we told the earlier things where we said it is gada drishta gadad vinnaha, same way sharira drishta sharirad vinnaha. So, just as you see the pot and the pot is different from you, you are experiencing your sharira as an object. So, how do you say you are the body is the question. That is the logic which they asked. Now, and Shruti, here he is quoting a Shruti from Taittiriya Aranyaka, a Shruti Vakyam to say the same thing. Varda Vinirni Nirnayitam Karyate. Shruti Vakyam also is giving the Nirnayam that Purusha Lakshanam, what is the Purusha Lakshanam? So, Evam Shrutya Dehatmano Vailakshanya Muktva Shrutya Api Aha Yasmadhin. So, Dehatmano Vailakshanyam is being quoted in this particular mantra of the Taittiriya Aranyaka. Yasmat param na aparam asti. So, yasmat param na aparam asti. There is nothing other than that, asmat param, super than, superior than that. Kinchit yasmat aniyoham. There is nothing which is smaller than that also. Anoraniyan mahato mahiyan. And also, na jayaha asti kinchet. Neither it is taking birth. Jayaha, janmanat, ityartaha, na jayaha. It is neither taking birth. Also, it is saying, vriksha iva stabdo divi tishtati ekaha tadanekam. Tadatan tena idam. Purna Purushena Sarvam. So he is giving an upama here. Like in the Divi, in the ethereal world, like a tree unmoving, but at the same time, Sarvam Purnam Purushena. हियर पुरुषेण इज अ तृतीया बट इट इज इन अ भावकर्मण मीनिंग सो पुरुषेण सर्वं पूर्णः तिष्ठति तिष्ठति एक एन तत् इदम् सो द एंटायर यूनिवर्स इज दैट पुरुष इज स्टैंडिंग लाइक ए अनमूविंग ट्री द उपमास विच इज इन द श्रुति इन द वेदास आर ऑल यूनिक इन इट्स ओन नेचर For example, we know that in the Gita, na urdha moola matashyakam ashvattam brahuravyayam. There also the tree is being used as a thing which is the roots are into the heaven and the branches are to the down. So same way here, divi stabdaha vrikshaha iva purnam jagat purushena tishtati. So that purushaha or atma is the one which is becoming the whole world outside. So here also what is having iti taya prasiddhaya taitriya shrutya iva iti karane tritiya purushasya atmanah lakshanam. So here that trit purushena iti purushasya atmanah lakshanam. So that is kartari tritiya is being used is in the coming in the next sentence. So iti karanatinim, so here purushena means if you take the other way, not the kartari, the third tridiyartam, purushahe, purushaha evas sarvam, sat purnam, divi stita vriksha eva. So that is which is like a tree which is from the heaven spreading into the whole universe. And that doesn't move when it is sat. The whole thing is being that eva purusha eva. So that is the purusha, the puman purushaha. Katam syat, how? Vimudena, vigatamuda bhavena, atichaturena, srutyartha, vivechana kushalena, ityartha. So, vimuda, that those who are vigatamudaha, who have got distorted mind, even though they are vivechana kushalaina, even they know that how to analyze it, the kartari tritiya nirnidaha vicharaha stapitam anyat purvavad. So like the earlier slokas it is there, here the purushena sarvam vyaptam. So that shruti vakya is also a example for that one in this particular, the Acharya is used one sloka, but then I remember I can tell you the other one. Soka meta bahusyam prajayeti, that is also comes in Taittiriya only. So ajayamano bahuta vijaya is another one. So even though ajayamanaha, so tatra chanans, even though he doesn't take birth, bahuta vijayate, it appears to have become many. So all these Shruti Vakyas are what he is saying is that it is the same Atma which is there in all the bodies as a perceiver, experiencing through the different bodies. At the same time, that is Eka Eva. For that, there is no Vikara which is happening. Jati Janma Mriti Shad Vikara Vriddhi Apakshaya Nasha Ityari Shad Vikara Nasti Tasmin. So then doesn't have any changes in that, and that is being told by the logic, yuktya, now shrutya, and it is our anubhava. If you extrapolate that what Shruti said or what the yukti has said, it doesn't have any change. It is absolutely right. Stapitam anyat purvavat yata shrutya iti kartrupadam asmin pakshe. Now here he is twisted the whole explanation. He is making Dehatma Vadin is Vimudhena is a Tridiya Padam, Tridiya, with the In Pratyaya, because of the In Pratyaya, he has made it as a Pradama and made it as a Sambodhana. So Vimudhena, Vimudenau, Vimudenaha. So I mean, there was no need for making this I mean, just wanted to show that he is using some special grammar rules here. Basically, what it is saying is that Dehatma Adinam Prati Murkha Shiromani Twad. It is the supreme idiotism or foolhardiness. So he is the Swamin of the Vimodas. That is why the Inpratya is being highlighted by the Acharya here. He is the epitome of foolishness or foolhardiness. Murkha Shiromani Twad Eva. Ati na adriyase is na adriyase means is not changing. It's used as a negative vartab here. There is no change in the Murga Shiromani. Doesn't think differently. He is still vivekuchalana asti chedapi. He is not using his brain to differentiate between what the Shruti is saying and his own experience. That the Dehaha is not the Atma. Dehaha drishtatvad anyaha. That is what it is being explained in this three shlokas. And in one more shloka, he is concluding that Dehatma Vadin. Mitra, this Vijaya Bhagini is Siva.
आम जी सम्यक् एव अस्ति अत्र किञ्चित् वक्तव्यं खलु तत्र परिमाणम् अस्ति चेत् तत्र प्रथमम् अस्ति अस्ति जायते वर्धते परिणामम् अस्ति अनन्तरं क्षीयते अस्ति क्षीयते नश्यति एतत् परिमाणरूपेण षड् विकारः अस्ति
आम् सम्यक् अस्ति भगिनि धन्यवादः अत्र पञ्चत्रिंशत् श्लोकं पठतु 35th श्लोकम् Can you read that? Vijaya Bhagini?
Amji. Sarvam Purusha Yeveti Sute Purusha Sanjite Apyuchyate Yata Srutva
Srutya
Katam Srutya Am कथं स्यात् दहकपुमान् अस्तु अग्रे पठनीयं वा पदच्छेदः सर्वं पुरुषः एव इति पुरुषसञ्जिते अपि उच्यते यतः श्रुत्या कथं स्यात् देहकः तत्र उपमानीयः आगच्छति खलु जि तत्र
देहपुमान् देह श्लोक इट् विल् कम् बट् इन् द पदच्छेद अण्ड् अन्वय यु केन् रीड् इट् सेपरेट्लि
देहकः पुमान् अन्वयः सर्वं पुरुषः एव इति पुरुषसञ्जिते अपि उच्यते यतः श्रुत्या कथं स्यात् देहकः देह कः पुमान् न केवलं न एकया किमर्थं श्लोक द्वे आगच्छति एकमेव आगन्तव्यं खलु न केवलं न एकया श्रुत्या विनिर्णीतं चित्वं किन्तु अन्यय अपि इत्याह सर्वमिति यतः हेतोः श्रुत्या वेदाख्य परदेवतया पुरुष एव इदं सर्वमिति पुरुषसंज्ञिते सूक्ते अपि उच्यते पुरुषलक्षणमिति पूर्वश्लोकात् अद्याहरः अतः कथं स्यात् इति पूर्ववत् अद्याहारः इति किञ्चित् तत्र लोपः अस्ति चेत् पूर्वतन श्लोकात् अत्र आगच्छति अतः एव तत्र पूर्वश्लोक अध्याहारः इति तत्र उच्यते
धन्यवादः भगिनि सर्वं पुरुष एवेति इस अ पुरुष सूक्त दैट इज वाई सूक्ते पुरुष संप्तिदे अपि उच्यते यतः श्रुत्या कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् नौ हियर से अन्वयः सर्वं पुरुष एव इति पुरुष संप्तिदे अपि उच्यते यतः श्रुत्या कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् हियर दिस इज द सेकंड श्रुति ही इज रेफरिंग टू विच इज अ पुरुष सूक्तम् पुरुष एवेदगम सर्वं इज फ्रॉम द पुरुष सूक्त न केवलं न एक ऐक्य श्रुत्या नॉट वन श्रुति विनिर्णीतं किंतु अनन्या अपि इति सर्वं इति अनदर श्लोक अनदर श्रुति आल्सो ही इज कोटिंग हियर सर्वं इति यतो हेतो श्रुत्या वेद वेदाख्या परदेवतया पुरुष एवेदगम सर्वं इति पुरुष संहिते सूक्ते अपि उच्यते सो पुरुष सूक्तम इज आल्सो ही इज बीइंग कोटिंग हियर सेइंग दैट वेद इन द वेद आल्सो परदेवता इज आल्सो कॉल्ड पुरुष एंड दैट पुरुष इज एव इदं सर्वं दैट पुरुष इज सर्वं सो सर्वं खलु इदं ब्रह्म पुरुष एवेदं सर्वं ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर मीनिंग इज द सेम पुरुष संजिदे मीन्स द नेम पुरुष इज द सूक्त इज उच्यते पुरुष लक्षणम इति पुरुषस्य लक्षणम व्हाट इज दैट सर्व इदं ऑल दिस इज पुरुष ओनली सो पूर्व श्लोकात् अध्याहार व्हाट कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् इति पूर्ववत् So from the previous sloka, we have to adhyahara or anuvritti, we have to take it that the question remains the same. How can the puman be dehaha? So here he is giving the second reference to the Purusha Sukta. Purusha evedam sarvam. The entire, the idam sarvam. Idam sarvam means idam sarvam jagat. Purusha eva. So I told you the other part is ajayamano bahudha vijayate. स्व काम यदा बहुधा प्रजाएति देयर आर डिफरेंट श्लोक डिफरेंट श्रुति स्टेटमेंट्स व्हिच इज एक्सप्लेनिंग दिस सेम मीनिंग दैट इट इज दैट पुरुष व्हिच इज बिकम मेनी और हैज बिकम द वर्ल्ड नाउ इन व्हाई दिस इज सो व्हाई इज द श्रुति बीइंग कोटेड एज पुरुष लक्षणम If that is the case, how can you call the Deha as the Purusha? The Purusha has to be in one uniformity, has to be the same in everything. That aspect is not happening in the Deha. Vikaratvat, Drishtatvat, Shadvikarat, Karanatvat. All these reasons the Deha is Vinnaha from the Purusha. And Aham Pratyayalambanatvena Sarvada सर्वस्मिन् देहे एकत्वेन एव तिष्ठति सो इट इज रिमेनिंग एज द आईनेस इन एवरी लैंग्वेज एवरी बॉडी एवरी पर्सन हू इज एक्सपीरियंसिंग द आईनेस इट इज द सेम एंड इट डजंट गो थ्रू द सृष्टि स्थिति लय षड विकारादि भाव सो हाउ कैन दैट बी द पुरुषः इज द कथं स्यात् देहक पुमान् कम अहम अयम पुरुषः कथं देहक देहः स्यात् Iti, this is the how the five slokas were. He is categorically, Acharya is categorically vilashanyam between the difference between the body and the seer of the body or the perceiver of the body or the experiencing or the one who sees the body. You have to differentiate between the two. So our attempt on all those things is for the aparokshanubhuti. So towards the aparokshanubhuti, we need to know these differences. That is what the Acharya is harping upon again and again. Now, having finished the Dehatmavadin, he is going to take the Mimamsakas in the next sloka onwards. So, that we will take it in the next class. Any questions on these five slokas which we did today?
No, Ji.
No, Mother.
Shobha, Lalita Ji.
नो महोदय तत्र पुरुष इत्युक्ते आत्मा इति यत्र कुत्रापि पुरुष इति अन्वयः अस्ति चेत् आत्मा एव किल शास्त्रे
पुरुष बेसिकली पुरुषायनात् पुरुषः ही इज द ऑक्युपायर इन द बॉडी और द वन हू सीज थ्रू द बॉडी और एक्सपीरियंसिंग थ्रू द बॉडी एक्चुअली ही हैज नो कर्तृत्व ही इज नाइदर सीयर ऑर ही यस्य प्रकाशेन इन द गीता श्लोक न मयाध्यक्षेन इज द स्टेटमेंट विच द भगवान मेक्स इट द मियर प्रेजेंस इट इज इन द बॉडी बिकम्स ए परसीवर and the thinker and all those experiences of the body is happening. So purishayana purushaha sa purushaha dehat bhinnaha. So it is different from the body.
Oh.
Yet in the vyavahara level when it comes to that, our day to day experience and the transaction of the world is that as if we are the body. Anything happens to the body, we feel bad for it. Anything happens with the relations with the body, there is a cause for happiness or a cause for sorrow, that is being for the on the body level. Mama, aham, mama, this thing. But aham pratyalambanam, which is observing that what is happening, is dehat bhinnaha. It is different from this thing. That is what is aham, not the deha, is what is being harped upon again and again by the acharya in the five slokas. So try to differentiate between what is happening through the body, with the body, and belonging to the body, and you are an observer to all that, not the body who is going through those changes or inflictions or the sukha dukkhadi. That has to come through a manana, vichara, viveka vichara, we spoke in the first few slokas, how does the viveka help for that? So to establish those things is bringing one by one aspect of that for us to make our understanding very clear that we are not the deha.
Amudaya, dhanyavadaha. Tatra aniya iti anuhu ityasya paryaya vachaka padamva?
Anoraniyan mahato maniyan, you might have heard it.
तत्र अणोर अणीय इति तत्र दत्तं किल दट्स् वाट् ऐ रोट् डौन्
दट् इस् एन् आर्षप्रयोग
अस्तु अणुः अणीय द्वे अपि समानम् अस्तु अस्तु महोदय
एनी क्वचिन्स् अदर्वैस् विल् स्टाप्
न धन्यवादः
ओके ॐ पूर्णमद पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः हरिः ॐ श्रीगुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ॐ धन्यवादः नमस्कारः
धन्यवाद
धन्यवाद
महोदय
हरि ओम धन्यवाद।